Hi guys, I'm Shyam from websitelearners.com. Today we're going to see how you can create a separate page for your blog posts. Now, when you first launch your WordPress site, you might have noticed that all of your blog posts are shown on the homepage of your website. Today we're going to see how you can move those blog posts from your homepage to a separate page like this. So by putting your post on a separate page, you'll be able to have a well-designed homepage like this, where you can put your own content. Okay guys, so let's get started. First, let's take a look at our website. So this is a default WordPress site where we have all of our blog posts on the homepage. Now, if you want to put these posts on a separate page, we need to first create a new page called blog. Okay, so let's go to new and let's click page. Now we will call this page as blog and click publish. Okay, so our new page has been created. Let's see it by clicking view page. And you can see that we have a new page called blog. And right now this page is empty. Okay, and now if we go to our home page, you can see that our blog posts are still here. Now, how do we bring these blog posts into the page we just created? So to move these posts, we need to change our homepage settings in WordPress. So to change our settings, let's go to our dashboard. And then go to settings. And click reading. So here you can see that in this setting, our homepage is set to display our latest posts. So instead of this, we are going to change it to a static page. So once we do that, we can now select any page we want for the home page and the post page. So since we just created a page for a blog post, let's click here and select blog as our post page. And once we select it, we can just click save. And now if we go here, you can see that we are on our blog page right now. And it was empty. Now, if we click refresh, you can see that all of our blog posts appears on this page. So we have successfully moved our blog posts into a separate page called blog. But what about our homepage? Now, if we go back to settings, you can see that we have not yet selected a page for our homepage. And if we click here, you can see that we only have one page called blog, which we just created. So this means we need to create a new page, which can be set as our homepage. So to create a new page, let's go to this tab. And let's go to new again and click page. We'll call this page as home. And here you can enter any content which you want to put in your home page. I'm just going to type some sample text. And everything you put here is going to appear on your home page. Okay, so let's click publish. And we'll go back to the settings page. And click refresh. And now if we click here, you can see the new page we just created. So let's select it to set it as our home page and click save. Okay, so our home page settings have been saved. Now let's look at our site by clicking visit site. And you can see that the page which we just created appears as our home page. So we can say this is our home page by looking at the address here. We are right now on quicktechie.com, which is our homepage. So you can see that we have our homepage. And if we go to blog, we can see our blog posts. Okay, so let's go back to our homepage again.
Now, what if you don't want just text on your homepage? And instead of that, what if you want to have a better looking homepage like this? which has a much better design. So if you want to build a page like this, you need to install a plugin called Elementor. Okay, so let's go to part 2 of this tutorial where we see how you can design your homepage.
So to design the page, we are first going to install the Elementor plugin. So to install it, let's go to our dashboard. Let's go to plugins and click add new. Now let's search for a plugin called Elementor. And you'll get this plugin which says Elementor Page Builder. So let's click install now. And click activate. Okay, so Elementor is now installed. Next, let's see how you can design your homepage using Elementor. So to design the page, first let's go to our site by clicking visit site. And you can see the old homepage. Now let's click edit page. And you can see that after installing Elementor, we got this new button called edit with Elementor. So let's click that. And now we are in the editing mode where we can design our homepage. So now by default, we are only able to add content to this area. But if you want to use the whole page, we can tell Elementor to use the full width of the page. So to change that setting, all you have to do is go here and then click settings. And in the page layout, choose Elementor full width. Now this will allow you to use the full width of your page. So you can see that the usable area has been expanded to the whole page. So now let's start designing our page. To design our page, you have two options. Let's look at the first option, which is using blocks. So to build your page using blocks, all you have to do is click add template. Now make sure you are on this tab here, which says blocks. And here you can see different types of sections you can add to your site. So first, I'm going to add this section. I'm just going to click insert. And you can see that the section has been added to our page. Okay, so next we'll add another section. We'll click add template. And I'll choose this section. And it'll be added. Okay, so now we have added two sections. So once you have added all the sections you want, you can now start adding your own content. So to add your own content, just select the text you want to change. And then start typing your text. So that's it. The same way you can change any text you want. Just select the text. And then enter your own text. So once you're done, just go here and click update to save all the changes. And then to view the page, just click this button here. And you can see that we have just created our homepage. So we have a unique homepage. And we have a blog page, which has all of our blog posts. Okay. So this is how you can build your page using blocks. Next, let's see the second way to build your page. So to try it, we'll go back to Elementor. And let's delete these sections which we added. So we have deleted all the sections. Now the second way to build your page is by using pages. So to build your page using pages, just click add template. And instead of blocks, let's go into pages. Now, when you go into pages, you can see a lot of ready-made designs which you can use for your site. So let's say you like this design for your homepage. Just go here and click insert.
Now, as soon as you click it, you will get that entire page into your site. Now, all you have to do is just go to the places where you want to change the text, select it, and then enter your own text. So that's it. So you have a perfectly designed page, which you can customize as you wish. So once you're done with all the changes, you can simply click update. And then to view the page, just click this button here. So that's it. So you can see how the site is looking now. So this is our homepage. And this is our blog.
So that's it, guys. This is how you can create a separate page for your blog posts, okay? Now, if you don't see these pages in your menu, you can watch this video to see how you can create a menu in WordPress.
Next, if you want to design your blog page, you can do it with the pro version of Elementor, which is given in the link below this video.
So thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.